Hi, I'm Debbie, and welcome to my channel, Divine Destiny with Debbie. Today we're reading for March 13th and 14th, Wednesday, Thursday, for my Aries. Hello, Aries, how are you? Hope all is well. So, this is the short reading, so I just used my Doreen Virtue Angel Tarot cards. I have prayed, meditated, and infused with Reiki energy, and this is just a general reading. It may or may not resonate with you. Take what you like, leave the rest. So let's see what's going on for my Aries. Not picking up anything too dramatic, which I like. I mean, you know, sometimes saying, oh, you're going to have a regular day, that's kind of actually nice, especially if you've had a lot of drama, and I'm not quite sure where I'm going with the drama. So maybe, you know, there's been some drama, and I'm not necessarily picking up. So let's see. Let's go on here and see. Okay, one more time to shuffle for my Aries. Aries, Wednesday, Thursday. Okay. My Aries. Okay, this card is reversed. Here we go, the King of Earth. So this is a very professional card. This is a very statuesque card, okay? So I feel like it's kind of like you yourself being very much very regal, okay? Now, this is, Earth is of course our Capricorn, our Virgo, and our Taurus energy, and this is generous, professional, responsible, practical, a successful time. Confidently accept opportunities you're offered, the Midas touch. So I'm feeling this kind of like, you know, this presence, this Aries presence, and it's like very, it's very statuesque. I hope I'm saying, yeah, statuesque. It's very almost, it's not intimidating per se, but it is very, it's kind of overpowering. You know, it's almost on the brink of being overpowering. So you want to watch that unless you need to use that, and then go ahead and use that. But it's this sense of fullness, you know, where somebody says you're full of yourself, but it's not necessarily something that is negative. I feel like you're going to be in a position where you need to be full of yourself, okay? You need to know who you are. You need to be able to say, this is it. Okay, let's see what this next card is. The Ten of Water. Now, the water, of course, Cancer, Pisces. We're still in Pisces season. And Scorpio. And we've talked about that. You're fire. So water, you know, water can put fire out. But water can nurture you, nourish you. It can also drown you. You know, sometimes water can be overwhelming. And this one is a contented and rewarding family life. Your emotional and material needs are met. Trustworthy relationships. So here it is again, maybe this is why you are full of yourself. Maybe you're just feeling like just so much like, wow, I feel great for a change. This is lovely. I love this feeling that I'm feeling. Let's see what this last card says. And this one is reversed. So let's see. The Four of Air. Okay, Air is our Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius energy. It's our Wi-Fi energy. It's the thoughts that are coming through. Time to rest or take a vacation. Allow more time before making a decision. Meditation may provide answers. So what I'm kind of getting is that there's this, you know, so, and again, I don't want to be, you know, pessimistic. So really, because I really think that this is good energy. But it's like I'm feeling that you may, because of this, you know, this feeling of self-worth, which I think you're deserving, I want you to just guard against going a little bit too far with it, okay? Guard against, you know, being a little bit too imposing with it. Guard. I'm not saying not to do it. I'm just saying guard against it, because I'm feeling that, you know, that when, you know, for this Wednesday, Thursday, you might have that, but then here comes Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, and it might be, you know, and you might have to live with the consequences of what Wednesday, Thursday had. But if you are going, if this is a time for you to present anything, you know, this is going to be a great time for you to present anything. You know, if you have to do a presentation for work, if you have to conduct a meeting, if you have to, you know, and I don't know why this is, but If you have to go on an audition, if you have to, and maybe this is for an interview too, this is great energy to have. Now, you do not want to come, it's really hard to balance self-confidence and not coming across too strong. That's hard, but you know what? You can definitely do that. You know how to do that. And you know how to read people. So if you think you're pushing a little bit too much, you can then pull back. You know how to read them with that. But I feel, and again, I don't know who's doing the audition, or it may, but it could be an interview. It may be that you're going for a promotion and they're wanting to see your work. And this is, again, it's like you've got to create that balance because you have all the right energy. You have all the right skill sets. You would not be putting yourself out there to apply for this if you didn't know you could do it. Okay? So this is actually good energy for you if you are trying to accomplish something along those lines. It really, really is. Now, it may not be great energy in a personal relationship, but you know what? It might not be bad energy either. So, sorry, wish I could give you a little bit more on that one. So, my Aries, as always, know that you are loved and be blessed. Bye-bye.